and that in everything to have a good and prosperous and social life. Well, I know everybody knows what is capital, but just to make things straight, so this is produce durable goods used in the production of goods and services. There are many types of capital, and actually not all of them would fit into this definition, because natural resources, for instance, they were produced, but not by us, by nature. Environmental capital, but we have many others, infrastructure, human capital, financial capital, social capital, so many other forms of capital that really fit well into this definition. Now, we are interested in human capital, and human capital is really special because it is us, we are human capital, differently from all other forms. And it has several dimensions. There is the family dimension, the social, and the economic. Despite being an economist, I am well aware of the importance of the other dimensions as well, and I think that everybody in this room also is. Now, there is an interesting paradox of human capital that perhaps has not been pointed out often. Everywhere, it is mostly families investing in the human capital of the offspring. So you could say this, of course, we know that also government, society invests through several channels, but the largest part is really families, including the time devoted by parents to the formation of their children. However, the return on that so-called investment, because it is not really an investment on their part, it goes to society at large. So that is a sort of paradox, and well, we are here really our intention also not only to give solutions to problems, but also we are very familiar with looking in an unconventional way to things. So you could say, well, this is the way things are. Your families are very important units of society, so it is expected that the parents will look after their children and they will invest, they will spend whatever it takes, if they can, regardless of whether they will get some benefit or not. But I think it is not really working like that. And we are seeing, especially in advanced societies, that families are reacting to this. And they're having less and less children because they can perceive that it is not really, there is no incentive for them to have children, no economic incentive. And even not an incentive in terms of family life, because family life is getting poorer all the time. So that is, I think this paradox is interesting. And then from this paradox follows a dilemma, which is reading from here, yes, we have two problems. One is the lack of incentives that is really leading to insufficient production, let's say, of human capital, because the production of human capital is not only education, but this is even the creation of new beings. The fact of having children, that goes towards the formation of human capital of society. We are having less children, so that families can invest more on each one of them. So we have this lack of incentive. That is one thing that you can see in some countries like Japan, Korea, Italy, several countries. We see population is really starting to decrease. On the other hand, I know that Paul does not like the word efficiency, but I think that efficiency, if properly defined, is always useful. You can perhaps not have a narrow view on efficiency, but the way that investment is taking place is not efficient because it is following dynastic lines. It's going from parents to children. And it is not always the well off parents do not always have the more gifted children. So it will often be the case that you have children who have nobody to invest on them, the perhaps geniuses, nobody will ever know. And then you have very dumb children of well-off parents, so it's not efficient in that sense. So what would be the solution to that? The solution, the obvious solution is, as it says here, the socialization of the investment in human capital. Rather than going through dynastic lines, going from generation to the next generation. So how to do that? Well, there is an obvious solution, which is the government.
Sorry, Hector, just because I know we'll run out of time before we have the discussion.
Please.
You have a specific proposal.
Yeah, it's coming.
Okay.
After this. So this would be the obvious solution, which is this redistribution, so government tax and provide for human capital formation for everybody. Unfortunately, it doesn't work. I mentioned that I lived the most large part at least of my adult of my life in Latin America, and actually good part in Chile. I am from Chile, so I know it doesn't work. I was there in 1973, September 11. So this is the proposal. There is another route, and this brings together, of course, human capital with finance. With the world of finance. The other route is securitization. It's a system whereby children, as they move through the different formative stages of the human capital, they issue bonds in an automatic way. Of course, this will involve big data, perhaps blockchain technology, or all these things could come because these are large systems. And in that way, everybody, regardless of the origin, would theoretically, it is important really, theoretically would have the capability of education, health, nutrition. So that is the proposal. We do not have much time. I will finish with this diagram that shows all the flows that would take part in that system, and that involve the creation of a kind of central authority that would supervise all this process. So the bonds as securities as they are issued, they would create records in that database, so they would know, that this agency would know who owns how much, to whom, when it was issued, and later in life, when these individuals are already part, they can generate revenue, they would pay, repay also through that agency. In the middle, of course, the financial system would be there, and the adult population would be purchasing these securities, because it would be like form of their retirement. So of course, all this is can be explained in much more detail, but we need more time, which we do not have. But the idea here was to launch this idea, which really, once you look at it in detail, is quite transformational.